this is Thursday's sunset, but you can pretend that it's Friday morning's sunrise. Hey, I would appreciate it today if you would pray for my nephew Michael, who is having brain surgery today. Please pray for Michael. So King Nebuchadnezzar has a dream that troubles him, and he calls for his wise men and his advisors and tells them to tell him what the dream was and then to interpret it. Well, of course, they can't. And they say to him, "What the king is asking is so difficult that no one can make it known to him except the gods, whose dwelling is not with mere mortals." Well, those wise men got it wrong on two counts. First of all, they're talking about gods, and gods exist only in man's imagination. They didn't know the one true God, the maker of heaven and earth. If they did know that God, they would know that indeed he does dwell with men. They would know that this God said, "All nations will know that I am the Lord." They would know that his chief desire is to be their God and for them to be his people. And for you, as for you and I, remember Isaiah 57, verse 15. Listen. "For the high and exalted one who lives forever, whose name is holy, says this, 'I live in a high and holy place, and with the oppressed and lowly of spirit, to revive the spirit of the lowly, and revive the heart of the oppressed.'" You remember that Jesus said, "Lo, I am with you always, even to the ends of the age." Michael, I pray that you will know that he's with you today and always. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the same, the name of the Lord is to be praised.